God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Son, to be our mother and our queen, graciously grant that, sustained by her intercession, we may attain in the heavenly kingdom the glory promised to your children, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Reading from the book the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed, as on the day of Midian. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder, dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. with you.
And
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Gather today to observe the centennial of the Apostolate to the Sea and the observance of our own anniversary with the Seafarers Center, all under the patronage of Our Lady under the title of Stella Maris. Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Star of the Sea, Stella Maris in Latin, has a fascinating etymology that goes back to the earliest centuries of Christian history. As happens so often in sobriquets, it was an accident that brought about this beautiful image. Or was it providential? This title of the Virgin Mary comes to us by way of a Latin translation by Saint Jerome of the 4th century onomasticon of Eusebius of Caesarea. The onomasticon is itself a fascinating work. It is a lexicon of names found in the Bible. Saint Jerome's goal was to make the significance of these names, originally in Hebrew and Greek, to make them available to a wider audience in Latin. When Eusebius came to the name of Mary, which in Hebrew is translated or transliterated Miriam, he rendered the name in Greek as Mariam. He saw Mariam as deriving from two Hebrew words meaning drop of the sea, mar, drop, and yam, sea. To further embellish this, Saint Jerome accepted the explanation of Eusebius. I might add here, all of this etymology is quite controversial. But in those days, they relied upon the expertise of those who were closest to the documents. The explanation of Eusebius and Saint Jerome translated the name in Latin to Stella Maris, literally in Latin, a drop of the sea. At some point in the history of translations, the scribe, for an unknown reason, changed Stella to Stella, the Latin word for star. By the 7th century, Saint Isidore of Seville, being one of the first to use the term, star of the sea, was the accepted explanation given to Mary's name. Finally, in the 8th century, the great hymn, Ave Maris Stella, Hail Star of the Sea, entered the Marian hymnody to sing of Mary's role as the mother of the Redeemer, our guide in the stormy sea of life. Hail, O star of the ocean, God's own mother blessed, ever sinless virgin, gate of heavenly rest. Taking that sweet Ave, which Gabriel came, peace confirmed within us, changing Eva's name. Break the sinner's fetters, make our blindness pay, chase all evils from us, for all blessings pray. Show thyself a mother, may the Word divine, born for us thy infant, hear our prayers through thine. Virgin all-accepting, mildest of the mild, free from guilt preserve us, meek and undefiled. Keep our life all spotless, make our way secure, till we find in Jesus joy forevermore. Praise to God the Father, honor to the Son. In the Holy Spirit be the glory one. Amen. As star of the sea, Mary is our celestial guide. She points the way. Regardless of the title's origin, it is not the translation that gives us the notion of Mary as a star. leading the wayfarer to his destination. It is Mary herself who gives the term its meaning. The Doctor Mellifluous once expressed it so beautifully, and I quote from his sermon on the topic. If the winds of temptation arise, if you are driven upon the rocks of tribulation, look to the star, call to Mary. If you are tossed upon the waves of pride, of ambition, of envy, of rivalry, of fleshly desire, violently assail the frail vessel, call on Mary. Look to the star, call upon Mary. As the mariner sets sail, he is like the Christian, a pilgrim seeking his home port. He relies on the elements to propel him forward, but he must navigate the ship by coordinates that guide his vessel to its goal. The star beckons from the sky to follow. The star seems to echo the words of the divine messenger in the gospel, "Be not afraid." And the mariner responds, "Make our way secure till we find Jesus, our joy forevermore." So we voyage until the destination breaks upon the horizon, until calm waters overtake the storms at sea, for nothing is impossible for God. Having welcomed the word of God in faith, let us offer our prayers to God through the intercession of Stella.
Let us pray for all who govern us. Let us pray for the church and the Holy Father, Pope Francis, for our bishops, priests, and deacons, and for those who serve as chaplains or ship visitors of the Apostleship of the Sea. We pray for the Lord. Let us pray for all who govern us, that God may grant them wisdom and compassion. We pray today for governments and international bodies that enact laws that promote the welfare of seafarers, whose rights and dignities are so often violated by global industry focused on the pursuit of profit. We pray for the Lord. Let us pray for those on the margins of society, the poor, prisoners, the unborn, and the elderly. We pray especially for seafarers who work far from their homes and families, for those who are sick or have been injured in accidents on board ships, and for those who are ill-treated and frightened. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our own community, as we build from the devastation of Hurricane Laura, and for everyone living in our area, especially anyone who is in need. We remember all seafarers and their families, and ask God to comfort those who feel lonely and far from loved ones. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for a deeper devotion to Our Lady among all Christians, especially under the title of Star of the Sea, or Stella Maris. We pray that seafarers may find comfort and protection as they invoke her intercession. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for all who have died, especially members of our own family and community, and for all those lost at sea over the last year, as they work to bring us the goods we use and consume every day. We pray to the Lord.
Father, in your mercy, accept the prayers we make for ourselves and our neighbors, especially those who work at the sea, and for our own Seafarers Center. We make all these prayers through Christ, your Son, and our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray,
respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you.
Bestow them upon us.
with him and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my heart, but only say the word.
Thank you. the memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary, may merit to be partakers at your eternal banquet, through Christ our Lord.
This time we will line up for the procession. I will call the order of the procession as I call the group or the they'll just move to the back of the church in that order. Line up two by two. The two master ceremonies. The two banner bearers for the Apostleship of the Sea banner. The flag bearers for the U.S. flag and the Vatican flag. You'd get your flags and just stay in the back. The two flag bearers for the AOS flag and the Louisiana flag. The banner bearer for the Diocese of Lake Charles. The banner bearer for St. Michael the Archangel banner. The banner bearer for St. Joseph.